So let's see, I moved to Nashville 5 years ago now, originally from Grand Prairie, Alberta, Canada, which is just a short 45-hour drive from Nashville, Tennessee. And I just kind of went there to chase this crazy dream, you know? And I'm so glad that the chase has brought me over here. But before moving to Nashville, I was playing for middle schools and high schools, driving in a motorhome across Canada, convincing my parents I wasn't going to university. And on that adventure, I met the most amazing people, and especially the most amazing kids at these schools. And one of my very favorites that left such a mark on me was Grand Manan, New Brunswick. And it's this tiny little island. And I got to the school, and I could just feel that there was something different in the room. The way that these kids were really kind of looking out for one another. Played a show that night for the community. Parents and teachers came out, and one of the teachers pulled me aside afterwards and told me that part of the reason they brought me all the way over to that side of the island was to be a part of this grieving process. There had been a car accident there a few months prior with 5 kids from that school, 4 of which I was hanging out with all day and had no idea what they'd been through. And one of which, her name was Danielle. She was the star basketball player. She just graduated with the full ride scholarship. And she was taken in this school wreck. And I sat there with the teacher and I wept. And I was even more so moved by this town and everything they'd been through. And stayed in touch with the teacher, Miss Ward, and I worked it out that I got to fly back the following spring and surprise the kids for the high school graduation. It was so fun. I showed up and the whole town's piled in a room. The gym was kind of looking like this size. And, I mean, there's 20 kids graduating. That is the best kind of graduation on the planet. And Danielle's parents get on stage and they give their daughter's scholarship to Zoe, who was also in the car, who was her best friend a year younger. And there's not a dry eye in this room. And I looked on the wall and I looked at her jersey and I thought to myself, I have a lot of questions for God. You know what I mean? I really think it's okay to have those questions. I think there's healing in the honesty and in the raw conversation itself. And shortly after that trip, one of my best friends from home lost her little brother, and it put me in the place of spinning in those questions again. And the only way to process how I feel about those kind of things is to write about it. And I'm really grateful that we got to put this song out as the latest single. So thank you for listening to it out there. It means so much to me.
There's a jersey